Hi everybody, it's Shoul Ashar, a researcher at Salam Lab and the lab manager of Mansoura University Vertebrate Paleontology Center, MUVP. We are a team of researchers with a shared passion for vertebrate fossils and natural history. Among my co-authors, Professor Eric Seifert, a mentor whose work on paleogene mammals continues to resonate through his many collaborators producing original science. Dr. Doreen DeVries, a researcher at Ecosystems and Environment Research Center, Salford University. Dr. Sana Issaid, the Vice Director of MUVP and a PhD student at the University of Michigan. Dr. Mohammed Samah, the National Focal Points for Natural Heritage and the Director General for Central Parks of Egypt. And finally, Professor Hisham Salam, the Senior Author. Salam founded MUVP and initiated the first Egyptian school for studying vertebrate fossils. Over the past dozen years, Salam Lab has explored, discovered, and documented a lot of Egyptian fossils. Please allow me to introduce our latest discovery, one of the smallest rodents in the world, Qatronimes saffrutus. We have discovered this extinct dwarf rodent that lived in the Fayum Depression of Egypt in the Eocene epoch about 34 million years ago. At the time, Egypt had a tropical-like environment with forests, swamps, and a diversified fauna of animals with different types, sizes, and behaviors. The Eocene of Egypt is punctuated by the arrival of new lineages of rodent Fayum Eurasia, Anomaloroids, and Hysterocognathi. Hysterocognathi's rodent originated in Asia and came to Africa. Then, their descendant migrated to South America and gave rise to the South American caveomorpha. But here is the problem. Even back then, Africa and South America were really far apart. So, how did these rodents wind up to South America? The prevailing theory says these animals arrived in South America from Africa by transatlantic dispersal, which involved riding on floating masses of plant debris. In other words, they rafted there. We studied multiple specimens of the new taxon, two skull and large group of mandibles. But it wasn't easy. The specimens were very small, delicate, and adhered into the solid clay stone. So we had to make micro CT scan to be able to study these specimens in three-dimensional images. The specimens showed clear differences in the morphological characteristics of the upper and lower teeth. And by comparing them with the discovered rodent from the Afro-Arabia, we have noticed that they are totally different and they are belongs to a new genus that has never been discovered before. We named the new discovery Qatronimes saffrutus. Qatrani refers to the area of the discovery. Mes means mice in Latin, and saffrutus means tiny from the Egyptian Arabic dialect. The length of the molar of saffrutus is 1 millimeter, and its skull is just about 1.5 centimeters long. Saffrutus and his relatives witnessed the transaction between global warming and global cooling. We did not only record a new genus and species, but we also were able to record the first bones of the skull of an enigmatic clade to which the new discovery belongs to, called phiocricetomyine. Furthermore, the new discovery will enhance our understanding of the phylogenetic framework and the paleobiogeography of Hysterocognathi's rodent. Thank you.